1985, New York City was the site of an historic all-star reunion concert of the greatest jazz label there ever was. The event was a celebration of the relaunch of Blue Note Records. Founded in 1939 by two German immigrants, Alfred Lion and Francis Wolff, Blue Note would set the musical, artistic, and technological standard for jazz recordings. The label's early years were lean, but notably innovative. By 1955, however, a remarkable confluence of talented musicians, Alfred Lion's exacting yet soulful record production, recording engineer Rudy Van Gelder's clear and vivid sound, Francis Wolff's extraordinary photography, Reed Miles' unique album cover designs, and the bluesy, gospel-infused hard bop of Horace Silver and Art Blakey's Jazz Messengers hit home with the public. The Blue Note sound was born. The label had become the place where every young, cutting-edge jazz artist wanted to be. By 1980, the two founders had long departed. The label's influence and prestige had declined, and Blue Note had entered a dormant period. But in 1985, it was revitalized by veteran record executive Bruce Lundvall under the ownership of EMI Music. The label developed a distinguished artist roster and regained its former reputation. That remarkable rebuilding journey began on this night, February 22nd, 1985. Here's Herbie Hancock's legendary tune, Cantaloupe Island.
Thank you.
As members of the Miles Davis Quintet, pianist Herbie Hancock, drummer Tony Williams, and bassist Ron Carter became the most influential rhythm section of the 1960s and played on countless Blue Note recordings. Tonight, they are joined by Freddie Hubbard on trumpet, Bobby Hutcherson, and Joe Henderson on tenor saxophone as they perform Henderson's classic tune, Recordame. We'll be right back. In the early 60s, Bobby Hutcherson emerged as the first new voice on vibraphone since Milt Jackson 15 years earlier. Hutcherson quickly became a regular on Blue Note recording sessions and soon began making his own albums. The lilting waltz, Little Bee's Poem, is from his album, Components, which also featured Herbie Hancock and Ron Carter. They are joined tonight by Tony Williams and flutist James Newton.
Thank you.
Bouquet is a beautiful ballad and another Bobby Hutcherson composition. It was included on his album, Happenings. He performs it here with Herbie Hancock and Ron Carter.
Thank you.
In a few short years, Stanley Jordan had graduated from street busker to the first artist signed by the new Blue Note Records. His unique playing style, which involved retuning his guitar to be more like a piano and tapping the strings with the fingers of both hands, enabled Jordan to play melody, chords, and bass line simultaneously. The town hall event put him, at the age of 25, in the company of musical giants he'd grown up listening to. His apprehension turned to exhilaration by the end of his dazzling performance of Jumpin' Jack. guitarist Kenny Burrell made his first album for Blue Note in 1956. He is joined by Grover Washington and veteran Blue Note session players, bassist Reggie Workman and drummer Grady Tate. They chose to play a tribute to the late, legendary soprano saxophonist Sidney Bechet. The beautiful and haunting version of this song was originally recorded only a few months after the label began in 1939. But Summertime became Blue Note's first hit. Thank you. Art Blakey was the heartbeat of Blue Note Records. From 1947 to 1964, he was a key part of the label's sound, playing a joyful and soulful brand of hard bop that reached people the world over. His group, the Jazz Messengers, was a university of the road for a revolving cast of great musicians across three decades and five continents. Joining him here for his most famous hit are Walter Davis Jr., Reggie Workman, Johnny Griffin, Freddie Hubbard, and Curtis Fuller, performing Moanin'.
Thank you.
Tyner came to prominence in the John Coltrane Quartet. He was a versatile and expressive pianist who was in demand for dozens of Blue Note sessions in the 60s. Tyner began recording as a leader in 1967 and returned to the new Blue Note in 1985. Three stunning solo albums for the new label were inspired by his beautiful performance of this tune, Sweet and Lovely.
Thank you.
One of the first albums made for the new Blue Note in 1985 was a collaboration by label veterans McCoy Tyner and saxophonist Jackie McLean. Surprisingly, they had never recorded together for Blue Note. Now they are joined by trumpeter Woody Shaw, bassist Cecil McBee, and drummer Jack DeJohnette for this rendition of McLean's 1960 composition, Appointment in Ghana.
Thank you.
When saxophonist Charles Lloyd first heard remarkable young pianist Michel Petrucciani, he was inspired to come out of retirement to form a new quartet with the Frenchman. They soon joined the revitalized Blue Note label. For this concert, Lloyd was reunited with Cecil McBee and Jack DeJohnette, the rhythm section of his 60s quartet with Keith Jarrett. They performed Lloyd's tune, Tone Poem.
Oh,
When Blue Note founder Alfred Lion introduced Jimmy Smith in 1956, an entirely new soul jazz genre was born. Smith had revolutionized the sound of the organ and made it a blues and bop orchestra. His records were sales leaders and his influence on music immense. Lou Donaldson and Kenny Burrell were frequent collaborators with Smith at that time. All three are joined now by drummer Grady Tate for Donaldson's well-known tune, Blues Walk. Thank you. saxophonist Stanley Turrentine originally joined drummer Max Roach's quintet in 1959 and was signed to Blue Note as a solo artist shortly thereafter. He also played with Jimmy Smith on many recording sessions. They are joined now by Kenny Burrell and Grady Tate for a song that first appeared on Smith's album, Midnight Special. Here is Jay McShann's The Jumpin' Blues.
Thank you.
Kenny Burrell stayed on stage, together with Jimmy Smith and Grady Tate, for the debut performance of Stanley Tarantine's exciting new tune, Scratch My Back.
Mm-hmm.
Blue Note was always open to new sounds and new directions. In 1965, Alfred Lion signed pianist-composer Cecil Taylor, who had been hailed as the most innovative of the avant-garde. Taylor added his unique talent and style to this concert with a new composition, Pontos Cantados.
Thank you.
Enjoyed this special evening at Blue Note Records. Good night.